Hello and good evening. I'm Bobby Asher, director of Duke Performances. And on behalf of all of us here at Duke, we're delighted to welcome you here to Baldwin Auditorium for this virtual online performance by our very own Ciompi Quartet. The entire arts ecosystem of which Duke Performances is a part continues to find ways to connect artists and audiences during this time, including through virtual performances like this one, online masterclasses and conversations, and even virtual field trips for our students in Durham Public Schools. We appreciate your support of that work now more than ever. So be safe, wear your mask, and practice good social distancing. We're happy you're here with us today, and we can't wait to invite you back to a live performance here on Duke's campus or in Durham as soon as we can. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Stephen Jaffe, and it's great to be with you for this evening's concert. I hope hearing music in this ambiance will be as meaningful for you as rehearsing with the Ciompi Quartet has been for me this week. It's been like a drink of water for a thirsty man. I hope it'll do the same for you. I'm thirsty for the presence of music. There's a nice program note in your program, and you probably click some dials and so on to get to it, so I won't repeat what's there here. I just want to supplement what's there with a few comments. The poet Mary Oliver said that it was the job of a poem to bring threads from the spiritual world to the intellectual world. So to make a tapestry, you need some thread. That's one way you can listen to the String Quartet number 3, as a tapestry. The threads of my quartet are delicate. They're unforced and fairly unadorned motives, a handful of notes here and there. If you pay attention to them in the moment, you'll soon find yourself transported to the whole, to a whole world, including the silence in between parts of the poetic and intellectual whole. The other thing I want to say is that this is called String Quartet number 3, and it's not the first piece I've written for this ensemble. So, in addition to having to clear space out of my mind that competes with Beethoven, Bartok, and Elliot Carter, I also have to clear space away from Stephen Jaffe's first quartet and Stephen Jaffe's second quartet, because I want fresh territory. I want any ensemble that I work with to be a new one. So, in some ways, number 3 is a reimagining of the quartet, just as number 1 and number 2 were. So, it's a pleasure to be here with you, and I hope you enjoy the String Quartet number 3.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Hello, thank you so much for joining us for our first virtual concert from Baldwin Auditorium on our Duke Performances performance season. We're very excited to be presenting these three works for you this evening and appreciate your interest and support. Both the first and the third works are pieces that were written when the composers were really at their younger stages, and the Mozart in particular, which is coming next, was written when he was just 17 years old in 1773. It's a marvelous piece. I encourage you to look at the program notes for all three pieces on the program, but this one really has all the hallmarks of a mature string quartet, four movements in the traditional forms, but less complexity in harmony and a little bit shorter. It's a lovely work. Hope you enjoy it, and thank you again so much for being with us this evening.
Thank you.